What does the Bible say about church eldership? Should a church have a plurality of elders, or should a church have a single elder, a single pastor? And I think that the scripture teaches very clearly that a church is to have a plurality of elders. No matter how old the church is, the church should have a plurality of elders. If we look in Acts chapter 14, beginning at verse 21, and just to give you some background here, the Apostle Paul is about to, he's in the middle of his first missionary journey, and he's about to return and go through the churches that he had planted. Verse 21, we read this: "And when they had preached the gospel to that city and had taught many, they returned again to Lystra and Iconium and Antioch, confirming the souls of the disciples, exhorting them to continue in the faith, and that we must, through much tribulation, enter into the kingdom of God. And when they had ordained elders in every church and had prayed with fasting, they commended them to the Lord on whom they believed." So this passage is very clear that on Paul's first missionary journey, when he returned through to the churches that he had planted, he ordained elders in every church. Now you have to remember that these churches are about a year old. Paul's missionary journey, his first one, took about a year and a half. So his first missionary journey makes it very clear he ordained elders in every church, and these churches were less than a year old. The second passage I want to look at is Acts chapter 20. Acts chapter 20, beginning at verse 16. "For Paul had determined to sail by Ephesus, because he would not spend the time in Asia, for he had hasted, if it were possible for him, to be at Jerusalem the day of the Pentecost. And from Miletus he sent to Ephesus and called the elders of the church." So here we see that the church of Ephesus had many elders, had multiple elders. They did not have a single elder, but they had many elders. And this is true also if you read Acts chapter 15 and 16, you'll see that the church in Jerusalem also had many elders and not one single elder. No church in the Bible ever has one elder as the pastor of the church. All churches in the scripture have multiple elders. And we know that was church practice from the very beginning because of Paul's missionary journey. If we look at Titus chapter 1, verse 5, Titus chapter 1, verse 5, we see Paul's instructions to Titus concerning eldership. Titus 1, verse 5, Paul says, "For this cause I left thee in Crete, that thou shouldest set in order the things that are wanting, and ordain elders in every city as I have appointed thee." So again, we have elders being ordained in every city. I think this is very, very clear in scripture. And the last one I want to look at is James chapter 5, verse 14. James chapter 5, and we read this: "Is any sick among you? Let him call for the elders of the church and let them pray over him." So there is an assumption here that James is making, that the church, that if you're in a church, then you have multiple elders. I think that's clearly what the Bible teaches. And you know, it's very important that you have multiple elders, because if you have church discipline in that church, it's only legitimate if you have multiple elders to hold each other account. And I think that's very clear.